on the portals, he's waiting and watching, watching for you and for me.
Worship him the Spirit and the truth. And the song has reminded us on the need for us to come home, because he's talking to us softly and in a tender voice. So let's go to him in prayer. Almighty and everlasting King of Kings, Father, we thank you today for making today a day in which we have to honor you through songs, prayer, words of advice, and the giving. Father, we thank you, O Lord, because of your Son Jesus Christ, who died and paid a ransom price on the tree of Calvary to salvage us from our deplorable state. Father, we equally thank you for those who have obeyed this gospel call, who have abided in the word and continue to live therein. We therefore, O Lord, commit as many that have gathered this morning to worship you in spirit and in truth. May you, O Lord, forgive us in any way we have sinned against ourselves, against our fellow human beings, and against thy spirit. May you, O Lord, remove every negative tendencies that are capable of disrupting, distracting, and impede the worship of today. May you invite your angels, your presence, for this worship. While pleading and praying for those today who have various problems that they could not air out, we are seeking your presence, asking for your divine intervention in our lives. Remove all obstacles, remove all troubles, remove everything that will make us not to live a holy life in this Christian world. Lord God Almighty, bless our service of today. Bless our minister as he will come to minister those things which is hidden from the world but has made known to us, that we may continue to live therein in this world of sin. Lord God Almighty, we commit all our beloved ones who are not here now, as they will be coming. Protect them, guide their footsteps, and lead them safely to our worship place, that we all may jointly worship you in spirit and in truth. We are also committing those who have slumbered as a result of worldly pleasures, as a result of the oppression, as a result of the diversities of problems for which they cannot handle but accept you. We therefore pray, may you continue to reprimand them. May you continue to instill in them that love of fellowship, that love to honor you, that love to worship you, that love to abide by your word. O Lord in heaven, we commit all the churches of Christ here on earth into your divine care. May you continue to unify us with your word, because we believe your word is true. Be with the government of the day. Help them in their decisions, policies, and regulations, that they make the environment conducive that we may worship you in spirit and in truth. Father, we hand all the services of today into your divine care. All the brothers that will be speaking, all our listeners, all our visitors, we commit everybody into your divine care, asking you, O Lord, may you continue to guide us, protect us, and shower your blessings upon us, that that we might not go home today empty-handed. Help us to do according to your will. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen.
Would you turn with me to number, I believe it's 589. No, it's not. 598. All the numbers, just the wrong order. Number 598, please. After which we can have our intercessory prayer. Number 598. If you have it, let us sing. Standing on the promises of Christ my King, through eternal ages let his praises ring. Glory in the highest I will shout and sing. I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior, standing, standing. I'm standing on the promises of God, standing on the promises that cannot fail. When the howling storms of doubt and fear assail, by the living word of God I shall prevail. I'm standing on the promises of God. Standing on the promises of God, my Savior. Standing on the promises I cannot fall, listening every moment to the Spirit's call, resting in my Savior as my all in all. Standing on the promises of God,
standing on the promises of God. The church said amen. And amen again. Well, it certainly is a blessing to be here this morning. A blessing to be able to come together to worship God in spirit and in truth. Amen. 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 In a moment, we're going to open up our hearts in a way of prayer for all those that might have prayer requests. But before we get there, if you don't mind, we sing a hymn, hymn 745, Where Could I Go? Hymn 745, Where Could I Go? We certainly stand on his promises, and a promise certainly that if we are faithful, he is just to hear us. Amen. So certainly, where else could we go but to the Lord? Let us sing. Living below in this so sinful world, how hardly a comfort can afford. Striving alone to face temptation, oh, tell me where could I but to the Lord? And oh, tell me, where could I go? Oh, where could I? For I am seeking a refuge for my soul. Where, when I'm needing a Lord to save me, oh, tell me, where
number to the Lord. Neighbors I can, and love them everyone. We get along in sweet accord, but when my soul needs manna from above, and oh, tell me, where could I but to the Lord? And oh, tell me, where could I go? Where could I? For I am seeking a refuge for my soul. Oh, well, when I'm needing a Lord to save me, oh, tell me where but to the Lord. Life here is grand, with friends I love so dear. Comfort, comfort I from God's own word. When I face the chilling hand up, oh, tell me, where could I but to the Lord? And oh, tell me,
where could I go?
For I am seeking a refuge for my soul. My soul, I'm needing a friend, Lord, to save me. Oh, tell me, where could I but to the Lord? And oh, tell me, where could I go? Oh, where? For I am seeking a refuge for my soul. Well, when I'm needing a friend to save me, oh, tell me, where could I go but to the Lord?
Amen, amen. Again, at this time, before we go further into our worship, sometimes we come to worship with something on our mind, amen. Sometimes we come with things troubling us from the previous week, but it's good to know that we can go to God in prayer. Give them to Him and clear our minds, amen. So at this time, if you do have a prayer request, if you just raise your hand, and when called upon, if you share your prayer request, and then we shall go to God together in prayer. We'll start. Gracious Lord, we come asking prayers for all of us here, dear Lord, in the Camden Church and even in the neighboring congregations, dear Father, that you would just be with each and every one of us, dear Lord, that we would certainly be the image bearers that you would have us to be, that we would serve you fearlessly and boldly, dear Father, that, Lord, we would devote ourselves and continue to devote ourselves to you, to your will, and to your way. Father God, we pray and we ask all of these things, laying them at your feet. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray and ask it all. Let us all say, amen.
Our scripture reading for this morning will be Psalm 136. From the book of Psalm, the division is 136. Since these were written as songs, I can just imagine the call and response type of way of expressing it. And I sort of wish we could do it that way this morning, but this is not the time for call and response. This is the time for scripture reading. So in your hearts, may you repeat with me the end of each verse. Psalm number 136. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endureth forever. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, of the God of gods, for his mercy endureth forever. Oh, give thanks to the Lord of lords, for his mercy endureth forever. To him who alone doeth great wonders, for his mercy endureth forever. To him that by wisdom made the heavens, for his mercy endureth forever. To him that stretcheth out the earth above the waters, for his mercy endureth forever. To him that made great lights, for his mercy endureth forever. The sun to rule the day, for his mercy endureth forever. The moon and stars to rule by night, for his mercy endureth forever. To him that smote Egypt in their firstborn, for his mercy endureth forever, and brought out Israel from among them, for his mercy endureth forever. With a strong hand and with a stretched out arm, for his mercy endureth forever. To him which divided the Red Sea into parts, for his mercy endureth forever, and made Israel to pass through the midst of it, for his mercy endureth forever. But overthrew Pharaoh and his host in that Red Sea, for his mercy endureth forever. To him which led his people through the wilderness, for his mercy endureth forever. To him which smote great kings, for his mercy endureth forever, and slew famous kings, for his mercy endureth forever. Sihon, king of the Amorites, for his mercy endureth forever. And Og, the king of Bashan, for his mercy endureth forever. And gave their land for an heritage, for his mercy endureth forever. Even an heritage unto Israel his servant, for his mercy endureth forever. Who remembered us in our low estate, for his mercy endureth forever. And hath redeemed us from our enemies, for his mercy endureth forever. Who giveth food to all flesh, for his mercy endureth forever. O give thanks unto the God of heaven, for his mercy endureth forever. That is our reading for this morning. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the understanding of his word.
Amen.
Going to be singing hymn number 9 in the supplemental book, Holy Spirit Dwell in Me. Are we all there? I think this is one that we all know. Amen. Certainly, right? Let us sing.
A Holy Spirit dwell in me, touch my eyes that I might see all your goodness, grace, and power. Stay beside me every hour and be my drink, be my living bread. Keep me sheltered, keep me fed. A Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, dwell in me. Holy Spirit, comfort me. Let my heart be one with thee. When I'm worried, soothe my mind. Let me sweet contentment find. May I run this wicked race, filled by your amazing grace. A Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, comfort me. Holy Spirit, rescue me and set my soul completely free. And beside Jordan, make my bed. In God's bosom, lay my head. And let me live in a brand new place. See my blessed Savior's face. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, rescue me. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, dwell in me. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, comfort me.
Amen. Our next selection for this morning is going to be hymn number 825, I Love My Savior. Hymn number 825, I Love My Savior. We all there? Amen. Let us sing.
Jesus, my heavenly King, loves me, I know. Praises to him I sing, onward I go. Closely to him I cling, blessings still flow. I love my Savior too. I love my Savior, he loves me too. I seek his favor in everything I do. Walking with him each day, love life doth shine. Doing his will always, never repine. Kneeling to him I pray, thy will not mine. I love my Savior too. I love my Savior, he loves me too. I seek his favor in everything I do. Happy to serve my friend, lean on his arm. Rapture will never end, nothing alarm. Voices will sweetly blend under his charm. I love my Savior too. I love my Savior, he loves me too. I seek his favor in everything I do. We're singing, I love my Savior, he loves me too. I seek his favor in everything I do.
Amen. The last selection before our preacher comes up, we'll sing hymn number 826, I'll Be Listening, right next door. Hymn number 826, I'll Be Listening. And since we're all there, we can just go ahead and start.
When the Savior calls, I will answer. When he calls for me, I will hear. When the Savior calls, I will answer. Oh, I'll be somewhere listening for my name. Oh, I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. Oh, I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. And if my heart is right when he calls me, if my heart is right, I will hear. If my heart is right when he calls me, ooh, I'll be somewhere listening for my name. Oh, I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. Oh, I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. And if my robe is white when he calls me, if my robe is white, I will hear. And if my robe is white when he calls me, oh, I'll be somewhere listening for my name. Oh, I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. Oh, I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. Oh, I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. Yes, for my name. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name.
Amen and amen again. So what holiday is coming up this week? Not everybody answered once. So Thanksgiving will be on Thursday. Amen. Amen. Y'all don't mind if we tell the Lord thank you. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Oh, I just want to thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you, thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We thank you. Thank you, Lord. Oh, I just want to thank you, Lord. You have been and so been so good. You've been so good. You've been so good. Been so good, you've been, and so been so good. Oh, I just want to thank you, Lord. You have worked it out. You worked it out. You worked it out. Worked it out. You worked it out.
worked it out. Oh, I just want to thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We thank you. Thank you, Lord. Oh, I just want to thank you, Lord.
Amen. God is good. Amen. God is certainly worthy to be praised. Amen. God has blessed us, and God knows who we are. Y'all might have missed what I just said. Because God is like having friends that like you, still your friend, but they know you. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Because they know everything about you. They know the good parts, they know the bad parts, and they still your friend. Amen. God knows the good and the bad, and he still loves us. Amen. So certainly he is worthy of praise. Amen. It is certainly good to be here this morning. Certainly a privilege to stand before you to share the word of God. Lord, these past couple of days of just my heart has been meditating on this passage of scripture we're going to be dealing with this morning. It's good that we're here to deal with it. Amen. Amen, amen. So brother Ron kind of started to say something relative to the scripture, and we'll get into it quite deeply. But if you wouldn't mind, open your Bibles to the scripture which has been read to your hearing. Amen, amen, amen. It's good to have family in the house. Amen, amen, amen. Again, good to have Sunset Road in the house. Amen. Good to have Camden family in the house. Amen. Me and Aaron done got tight already. Amen. Done got tight already. We're working on an album this week. Anyway, don't worry about it. Amen. Amen. But Psalm 136. So I want to do this a little bit differently. Normally I just reread it, right? But I want to do this a little bit differently. And the reason I want to do this a little bit differently is because of the emphasis of the scripture. It's not Ryan's fault. But it's Ryan's fault. The scripture is up on the screen right now. And y'all see what's at the top, right? This is the New American Standard Version. So, for his loving kindness is everlasting. For his loving kindness is everlasting. For his mercy endureth forever. So here's what would typically happen in the temple. The cantor or the choir would read the first portion of the psalm, and the audience, or the other choir, that's Bible now, would respond with the refrain. So I'm going to read the first part, y'all read the second part. Amen? Now, New American Standard, it's the same thing. For his loving kindness is everlasting. Amen? So we're going back and forth. Amen? Amen. 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 Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
Give thanks to the God of gods.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
Give thanks to the Lord of lords.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
To him who alone does great wonders. To him who made the heavens with skill. To him who spread out the earth above the waters. To him who made the great lights. The sun to rule by day. The moon and stars to rule by night. To him who smote the Egyptians in their firstborn.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
And brought Israel out from their midst.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
with a strong hand and an outstretched arm. Time out. This is a worship song. We got to say it like we mean it. Amen? So I'm at verse 13. So I'm gonna get to verse 13, and y'all gonna be like, "How?"
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
Amen, Sister Spence. Amen. Uh-huh. To him who divided the Red Sea asunder.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
And made Israel pass through the midst of it.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
But he overthrew Pharaoh and his army in the Red Sea.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
To him who led his people through the wilderness.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
To him who smote great kings.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
And slew mighty kings.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
Sihon, king of the Amorites.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
And Og, king of Bashan.
For his loving kindness.
And gave their land as an inheritance.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
Even an a heritage to Israel, his servant.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
Who remembered us in our low estate.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
And has rescued us from our adversaries.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
Who gives food to all flesh.
For his loving kindness is everlasting.
Give thanks to the God of heaven. And all God's children said,
amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. For his loving kindness is everlasting. For his mercy endureth forever. That ought to get you excited.
Amen.
For his mercy endureth forever. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That's just a scripture reading. Huh. This week is Thanksgiving. Regardless of the brutal historical beginnings of that day, it has become a time of reflection and meditation. Many times during the meal, people will state what they are thankful for. Hopefully after the food has been eaten. Anyway, around this time, y'all ain't been there. Around this time, people start sharing what they're grateful for. They even start to share their gratitude journals, if you will. In the spirit of that theme, here in our text, we examine a psalm of unknown origin, we're not certain of the author, in order to grasp a key point. So if you would lend me your heart and ears to this thought, because of his mercy, certainly all of us are here today only because of his mercy. Some of us have gone through some things, but we're only still alive because of his mercy. We're in the position we're in because of his mercy. This month, we continue in our series on spiritual disciplines for sanity. Enough can happen in this world that will cause you to slowly lose your mind. Enough has happened even on the news that could make us lose our mind, lose our focus. And so this month, I wanted to focus on strengthening our minds, our mental capacity in dealing with all that our society and our lives will present us each and every day. 2 weeks ago, we looked at Daniel 6 to examine his reaction to his stressors in his life that could have cost him his life. Y'all remember the story. He was about to be thrown into the lion's den because he worshipped God. In that same way, he knew what it was. He knew what the decree meant, but he remained vigilant in serving the Lord. He was kneeling, thanking, and praying to God three times a day, even after they issued the decree. Last week, we focused on examining our schedule and carving out an extended time period in order to be alone with the Lord, as we took it from Matthew chapter 14. Amen. This week, if I could add one more discipline to your spiritual bailiwick, it would be in reference to the changing and the improving
of our attitudes. Amen. Disclaimer: this sermon will show up, or the result of this sermon will show up among the congregation in the next few weeks, month, and year. Amen. So pay attention. Amen. Pay attention, because this is an immediate thing. Amen. This is an immediate change that can take place. Because Lord, many times, y'all ever had a bad day or a bad week? Have you ever changed your disposition, made up your mind that you were going to just be encouraged no matter what? And all of a sudden your day and your week got better? What I'm saying is, it's your fault. So with that, our focus this morning is to look honestly at our lives so that we give thanks. Amen. It is to look honestly at our lives so that we give thanks. The first thing that I need to point out about this particular psalm is how it was used in those days. This is a responsorial psalm, and just very much the same way we did it this morning. It's designed for that purpose, that when individuals came to the temple, the cantor, the priest would speak and the people would respond. It's close to an antiphonal hymn, very much like we sing some antiphonal hymns. Humble yourself in the sight of the Lord. We'll sing that over and over again. Or He is more than able. It's to drive home an idea, a point inside your mind. They've been doing this since temple days, since even before that, when they came together to sing. So it is designed for your remembrance. What is the phrase that everybody remembers from just what we did a few moments ago? For His loving kindness is everlasting. Amen. It's to drive home that point, but it's to supplement it. It's a conscious marker. For His loving kindness is everlasting. Dealing with a subconscious implant. Because He freed us through the Red Sea. He defeated our y'all follow. That's the purpose of said psalm. Well, we're going to get into it a little bit more. It certainly is designed to change your association, but this is a liturgical psalm or a worship psalm. This is one of the psalms used to reference God. Camden notes, I had said it earlier, that the refrain, or "for His loving kindness is everlasting," the refrain was evidently sung as a response either by a choir of priests and Levites answering the choir, or the singer who chanted the first line, or by the entire congregation. There are, very simply, and I've said this before, but I mean it today, I'm not going to hold you long this morning. Amen. I'm glad you're not excited. Next week we're going 2 hours. Anyway, but the first part of the psalm, verses 1 through 9, actually deal with, and it's up there, but to point it out very plainly, is pointing to and recognizing the goodness of God. To look at just a few verses immediately, it says, the first verse, "Give thanks to the Lord, for He is good. For His loving kindness is everlasting." Give thanks to the God of gods. It's a separation. Now, what we're looking at right in these first 9 verses is Genesis chapter 1 language. What you mean? It talks about Him being the God of gods, the Lord of lords. It talks about what He has created, the big lights, the sun to rule the day, the moon and stars to rule by night. In that same manner, this is Genesis 1 language. The word would be Tov. As a matter of fact, you've heard it before, that the verse that would say, verse number 4 in our text. Oh, we got challenges today. But Genesis chapter 1 and verse number 4 would say, God saw that the light was what? Good. Luke 18, verses 18 and 19, the parable, or not the parable, but His interaction with the rich young ruler, Jesus said, is interacting with him, and He says, "Good teacher." And Jesus' response is, "Why do you call me good? There's only one good, and that's God." Now, if you were, I don't know if anybody ever was as curious as me when I was younger, but have you ever noticed how much the word good and God look like each other? Now, Tov and Yahweh are two different words, but good is the emphasis here. But the meaning behind that was that good always, a word of German origin, always referred back to God, speaking primarily of Jehovah. God is good. Amen. Y'all know we say God is good all the time and all the time. God is good. And we do that whole thing. But God truly is good. Quite literally, good, the word, only came from the English word God. Because good could only be associated with that which was always good. Y'all follow? So the mindset is good got to be God in the same way. That's what this psalm is emphasizing, the goodness of the Lord. Amen? The second part of this psalm is dealing with verses 10 through 22. It is speaking of his power. The verses would say, to him, verse 10, who smote the Egyptians in their firstborn, the last plague that he had on Egypt, and brought Israel out from their midst with a strong hand and an outstretched arm, to him who divided the Red Sea asunder and made Israel pass through the midst of it, for his loving kindness is everlasting. It was about his power is the emphasis that we see here. This is reminiscent, this speech is reminiscent of a war banner. Now, we don't do banners too much. If we're doing a parade like Armistice Day, or in Europe when they do Armistice Day and they have a banner, they'll have a flag and everybody would rally to that point. Well, back in the Old Testament, in those ancient days, that an army, when they're preparing for war, they would hold up a banner. And the banner had stuff written on it. Now, this language here actually is reminiscent of something else that happened in Israel's past. In Exodus chapter 17. In Exodus chapter 17, verses 15 through 16, the Bible says in this version, Moses built an altar and named it, "The Lord is my banner." And he said, "The Lord has sworn, the Lord will have war against Amalek from generation to generation." Now, some of your Bibles actually would have a translation, and most of us have actually heard this phrase, "The Lord is my banner," comes from the Hebrew phrase, Jehovah Nisi. We've heard that before, right? The Lord is my banner. Now, why is the Lord being a banner so important? War banners, as they were used back in the day, had a purpose. They had something on the front, they had something on the back. What they had on the front would say all of their victories, everybody who they beat, everybody who they overcame. And they would raise it, the soldiers would rally behind it, and they would march. And as they're going to enemy territory, the enemy would look at the banner to know what kind of person or group that they're dealing with. But it was a secondary purpose for the banner. The banner had the same image on both sides. It wasn't just for the enemy to see and say, they some bad boys, we got to be careful with how we deal with them. But it was to remind the soldiers, this is what God brought you through. This is what God blessed you to overcome. Y'all heard what I said. So the mindset is, we gotta get it in their mind who we serve, and we got to keep it in our mind who we serve. Amen. So in the same way to say, the Lord is my banner, is to say, I ain't worried about nothing. Y'all ain't heard me. You ever been worried and God work it out? And then you worry again and God work it out? Then you worry some more and God works it out. Amen. What we need to do is take a look at our banner, our standard, and say, God always working it out. Maybe I just need to keep my eye on him and his standard so that we keep marching for. Amen. Amen. That has to be our mindset. God is certainly our banner, Jehovah Nisi. Amen. Amen. The third part of this psalm speaks of his saving grace. Verse 23 and following would say, who remembered us in our low estate and has rescued us from our adversaries, who gives food to all flesh, he feeds everything. Give thanks to the God of heaven. The section of language is something that the people of Israel needed to be reminded of regularly. And certainly, it is possible, it still is, to take advantage of the Lord and completely forget who blessed you to be in the position you're in right now. It's possible to be following God and forget who you're following. Amen. Because sometimes we can get so caught up on taking advantage of what he does right now that we don't think about serving him. God got it. But there's a service. Amen. Because God is good. Certainly, every Sunday, we come together to worship. If I was to quote Brother Mervin, he has said it weeks in a row, Sunday is a day of celebration and rejoicing. Amen. Sunday is a day of celebration and rejoicing. Amen? Amen. Certainly God has done so much for us. He's worthy of being celebrated. Amen? Amen. Certainly God has just impacted our lives so much. He's worthy to be celebrated. He just ought to be celebrated. It's important to note why, though. The three points from the psalm that are important to grasp with this passage is that, number one, God is always good. Number two, God is always powerful. And number three, God is always merciful. If I could tie them, the New Testament, to the Old Testament, and we could just call them scripture. Romans chapter 12 verses 1 and 2 says, therefore I urge you, brethren, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies a living and holy sacrifice acceptable to God. Now King James would say, which is your reasonable service. That's actually not what it really means. It really means, which is your spiritual service of worship. In other words, how you live your life every day is worship to God. Amen. That person who pushed you and you started cussing them out, amen, guess who liked you did that instead of giving me my worship? Y'all follow what I'm saying? Amen. Every day, amen, every day, amen, is worship to God. Amen. How we walk, how we talk, how we conduct ourselves, amen, is worship to God. So if we just bug out for a moment and be like, well, I can pray about it on Sunday. Y'all been there? Amen. I know I ain't the only one that did that. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. I'm saying, because sometimes we can forget just how powerful and important God is. Getting so caught up in having right now that we miss. He gonna bless us. It's only by his mercy that we can have tomorrow. Amen. So in the same way, to sum up the point of our sermon this morning in relevance to the psalm before us, because of his mercy, we ought to live out our thanksgiving. Amen. We ought to live out how thankful we are each and every day. Amen. Because he didn't have to. Amen. He didn't have to bless us with the job, with the clothes, he didn't have to bless you with a right mind. Strap the other stuff, strap the clothes, strap all of that. He didn't have to bless you with the ability to think right. He didn't have to bless you with the ability to open your eyes. Somebody woke up this morning and couldn't see. Somebody might have had a warning and over time their eyesight was diminishing. Somebody woke up and it was gone. So to have it, to be able to look forward and look back at me, that's certainly a blessing. It's only because of his mercy. If you want to retain your sanity and the strength of your mind, then you got to look for reasons to be thankful instead of looking for reasons to be pissed off. Amen. That sounds strange, but sometimes we have a bad day, and sometimes it gets worse when we start to notice everything. Amen. Can I talk to the married men for a minute? Married men, y'all with me. It's just me and you. Ain't nobody else in here. Just married men. Let's talk. Amen. You haven't just been going about your day, might not be the best day. You get a call, text message, or you walk in the house and your wife say, why you leave your socks there? See, y'all ain't saying nothing. Y'all smart. Y'all near your wife. That's cool. My newlyweds right here. Y'all, but y'all, you just, uh-huh. You know what? I get that when I get back in. But it turns into a little bit of an argument. And that can steamroll into something else, not in the house, but outside the house. All of a sudden, you're like, oh, man, the tire light on. Because, you know, new cars tell you what the tire pressure is. So you're like, oh, it's down a couple points, man. I thought I put air in it. Then all of a sudden at work, you begin to notice everything that's wrong. And by noticing everything that's wrong, all of a sudden the day just became terrible. Because one bad situation. Church. Well, I started with the husbands. Husbands. Thank God. Amen. Y'all hear me? Amen. My wife right here. But y'all hear me? Amen. Thank God she noticed the sock on the floor. Right next to the basket, outside the basket. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Y'all laughing because you know what I'm talking about. But thank God that you got your wife. Thank God she noticed that. Because without her noticing that, it wouldn't cause you to wash the dishes. Y'all ain't heard me. Amen. See, the sister's laughing because y'all know, my wife turned her head and she like, y'all know what I'm talking about. Amen. The small things, Lord Jesus. I'm thankful, Sister Lily, she's down south with her family right now, but Sister Lily sat in the back right next to where Latoya's sitting and she said, I thank God for my pain because it lets me know I can feel. And I'm like, what? What? Because when we have pain, we just want to get rid of it. But thank God we can feel. Amen? Because there's a worse thing than having pain. It's having a numbness where you can't feel anything. Amen? It's dangerous in some situations. I remember Randy was up there talking about something. He was driving and couldn't feel his legs. God knows he was looking to see if he's pressing the brake because he ain't sure. Because he couldn't feel it back then. Thank God he's still safe. Thank God he keeps, amen. You got to look for reasons to thank God. Yes. Amen. Yes. Amen. That's my sermon for you this morning. Amen. I told you it's going to be short. Amen. Thank God. She's saying thank God. She's saying thank God. She thought thank God the sermon short, but thank God, amen. But thank God, why? Because you know what? You can change how your day, your week, everything just by changing what you're thankful for. Yeah. When was the last time you thanked God? If we're honest, it doesn't happen as much as we think we do. It's not until the end of the day come and now you're fishing through your whole day. What good happened today? And so we'll say yesterday was a bad day. But you want to know something? Thank God he woke you up. Thank God he didn't turn you off one day, amen. Thank God he blessed you to go out and work, amen. He blessed you with strength. He blessed you to be able, amen. He blessed you to have when others certainly don't. I grew up, and y'all grew up like me, and I ain't even keep talking, but yeah. Brother O, don't be offended by what I'm about to say. But I know you've been here many years. But see, the way we grew up in the hood was, it always was said that we had to finish our food. Because there were starving people where? I was always, why is it this narrative to always say Africa stop? Then I grew up and I got a little old and I realized, folks starving down the street. Folks starving next door. I ain't worried about them. I can't be focused on kids starving in Africa when kids are starving up the block. So thank God my mama cooked rice 5 nights a week. Rice and peas. But I know where I'm at. But anyway, but thank God for curry golden oxtail. Thank God that sometimes it's just rice and butter. Amen. Y'all with me? Amen. Thank God for syrup sandwiches. Y'all ain't riding with me. Thank God for that marinara sandwich. Y'all been with me. Amen.
Thank God for tomato. You just cut and take a bite. Amen. Thank God for the grapes. Thank God for the stuff that we thought was poor man food. Thank God for poor man food. Because some folk don't eat at all. We ought to look at our lives daily and say, Lord, truly I thank you. Because if not for you, I'm thankful for the accident that totaled our car. Because I thought the back seat caved in and crushed his seat and he was sitting like this. Thank God it stopped at the trunk. And while the car is totaled, thank God he's safe. Thank God I'm safe. Amen. Because it was bad. It was just, man, I'm so, why this got to happen? But like we discussed in our last series, that ain't nothing but Havel. Thank God we made it out. Thank God he blessed us to get some. Amen. God is good. God is powerful. God is merciful. And because of that, he's worthy of our thanksgiving. So I share with you this morning, listen. If you've not been zeroed in, focused on, kept your mind set on being thankful to God regularly, then today's the day to start. Don't pray that God will make you more thankful. Y'all didn't hear me. Don't pray that God will make you more thankful. Be more thankful to God right now. Be more thankful. He's done far too much for us to not be. Thankfulness ain't something he could bless you with. It just ain't. Thankfulness ain't something you could just pray and say, Lord, bless me to be more thankful. No. Maybe a discerning eye. But you can be thankful right now. Amen. Amen. There's a brother, he's a friend of mine, and I love him dearly. And so I'm not going to say his name, though. But every time I see him, that boy looks smooth. Came out of nowhere. Lord, you know, I'm so thankful to the Lord. He blessed me with money. I'm thinking he's going to say to pay for stuff and pay for his rent and all the other stuff like that. He said, money to buy this toupee, and it actually looked good. I'm just like, just be thankful. Amen. 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 Look, we're going to stand. We're going to sing a song of invitation. Right now is the moment in time to say, I'm changing my life to be thankful to God. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you. Thank you, Lord. Oh, I just to thank you, Lord. Thank you, thank you. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Oh, I just want to thank you, Lord. Because of his mercy, we ought to be thankful. Amen. It's at this point in time that we come together to remember what the Lord did on the cross. We remember what he did on the cross. We remember what he did on the cross by taking of this memorial feast that we now call communion. So if you have your psalm books and wouldn't mind turning with me to hymn 310 in Gethsemane alone. Oh, what a wondrous love I see freely shown for you and me by
the one who did atone, just to show his matchless grace, Jesus suffered for the race. In Gethsemane alone, and oh, what love, a matchless love, and oh, what love for me was shown. Forever I will be, for the love he gave to me. It was when he suffered all alone, and oh, what matchless love, and oh, what love for me was shown. His forever I will be, for the love to me. It was when
he suffered all alone.
Amen. I'd like to thank Ken for that amazing sermon.
Amen.
Keep the banner of God above our head at all times.
Amen.
Fixed on him while we continue this daily march.
Amen.
Part of our thankfulness, or our way to show our thankfulness when we come together on the first day of the week, remember the sacrifice that was made for us. And for that, I'll be reading 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verses 23 through 34. And the Bible reads, "For I received from the Lord that which I also delivered to you, that the Lord Jesus, on the same night in which he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and said, 'Take, eat, this is my body which is broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me.' In the same manner, he also took the cup after supper, saying, 'This cup is the new covenant in my blood. This do, as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me.' For as often as you eat of this bread and drink of this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death till he comes. Therefore, whoever eats this bread and drinks this cup of the Lord in an unworthy manner will be guilty of the body and the blood of the Lord. Let a man examine himself, and so let him eat of the bread and drink of the cup. For he who eats and drinks in an unworthy manner eats and drinks judgment to himself, not discerning the Lord's body. For this reason, many are weak and sick among you, and many sleep. For if we would judge ourselves, we would not be judged. But when we are judged, we are chastened by the Lord, that we may not be condemned with the world. Therefore, my brethren, when you come together to eat, wait for one another. But if anyone is hungry, let him eat at home. Lest you come together for judgment, and the rest I will set in order when I come." We also have this time around the single cups, so we're going to pray for the blood and the body at the same time. We're going to take them at the same time.
Let us give the thanks. Our God and our Father in heaven, Father, we give you thanks for this day, a day of celebration and thanksgiving where we come as believers in Christ, dear Father, to give you thanks for your Son and our Savior Jesus the Christ, who gave his life for us. Father, we thankful for this bread which represents his body. We ask you, dear God, that you bless bread and sanctify it. But most of all, dear Father, we pray that you bless our hearts and our minds, dear Father, that we remember Jesus died for our sins. Give you thanks in all things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, we want to thank you for all the blessings you have given us on a daily basis. We want to thank you for allowing your Son to come down and take away our
for me, but there no bitter moan for the 3 disciples slept. Oh, how my loving Savior wept. It was in Gethsemane alone, and oh, what love, a matchless love, and oh, what love for me was shown. Forever I will be for the love he gave to me. It was when he suffered all alone, and oh, what love, a matchless love, and oh, what love for me was shown. His forever I will be for the love he gave to me. It was when he suffered all alone.
Amen. Has anyone been overlooked? All right, we'll move forward. Likewise, in the same manner, when we come together on the first day of the week, we're also to give back a portion of which we can bless us with back to the church. I'll be reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 16, verses 1 and 2. Now concerning the collection for the saints, as I have given orders to the churches of Galatia, so you must do also. On the first day of the week, let each one of you lay something aside, storing up as he may prosper, that there be no collections when I come. Let's pray for the offering, please. Amen. Dear God and Heavenly Father, we come before your throne of mercy with heads bowed and humble hearts, dear God. Thank you for another day that is not been promised, dear God. We thank you for waking us up this morning, dear God, and for continually to bless us despite all the things that are going on in the world, dear God. You continue to bless us. You continue to allow us to move forward. You continue to give us a reason to smile, to give us a reason to love. You continue to bless us with things that help us appreciate all the things that that may be going on with us, dear God. If we would just look at it a little bit differently, dear God, to understand that we have pain so that we know what it's like to feel pleasure. We have things that will upset us, dear God, so that we understand, you know, what it means to be calm. We understand that these things are given to us, dear God, to help build us up, to make us better Christians, that we may be able to be leaders, dear God. Yeah. And we just want to thank you for that. We thank you, dear God, for giving us an opportunity to give back a portion of which we have blessed us with. We ask, dear God, that you continue to bless us, that we'll be able to continue to give more and more. We'll be able to do the work of the kingdom, dear God, that the funds will be used in a manner that is pleasing unto you, dear God, that it will be for the edification of your kingdom. We ask, dear God, that we do this, that we offer this in a manner that is pleasing and acceptable to you. Amen. All these blessings and thanks we ask in Christ the Lord and Savior's name. That's all that's said.
Amen.
Amen.
Jesus gave his life a ransom yonder on Calvary, on Mount Calvary, Calvary, paved the way by blood that we might win a bright shining crown. Well, you ought to praise his holy name. Salvation has been brought. Oh, glory, praise the Lord. Salvation has been brought from heaven. Go and shout and tell the world around. go preach it and
tell her today
to people in sorrow.
Tell her today
and tell it to ma. Preach the word of God that we might win in heaven's air. The Lord's salvation is full and to sinners spread the news all over the land and go teach it and inherit nations all over create. Praise the Lord, salvation has been brought. Oh, glory, praise the Lord, salvation has been brought from heaven. Go and shine and tell it the world. Go
preach it and tell it today
to people in sorrow. And tell it to ma. Preach the word of God that we might win in heaven. The law, oh, the law, salvation is full and to sinners spread the news all over the land and sea.
Teach it and
tell it afar. Tell it afar. Salvation has been brought down.
Amen and amen again. Certainly we've had a good time this morning. Amen. Worshiping the Lord. Amen, amen. Certainly, before we get into
okay, brethren, we thank God today for a successful service. And to add it all, we are in a Thanksgiving moment. So irrespective of what people are passing through or what they are saying today, we still remain thankful to God. So let's go to God in prayer. Oh Lord, our God in heaven, we thank you today for granting us a privilege to worship you in spirit and in truth. We thank you for the songs and praises. We thank you for the words of admonition. May you, O Lord, at your infinite mercy, engraft all these words into our hearts, that we might continue to meditate, put them in use, that we might not be the forgetful hearers, but help us, O Lord, to abide by your word. Help us, O Lord, to remain thankful, irrespective of the situation, conditions, all that has transpired in our lives. Help us to be thankful, especially for the air we breathe, for the security, for the food, for the light, for the accommodations, for all that you have made it. Many are sick, many are weak, many are in different hospitals as well as nursing homes. Many have lost their life in different ways. But on our side, O Lord, you have been a faithful God. You have been a God of protection. We say thank you, O Lord. Father, as we believe in this arena, we are committing our ways into your divine care. We are seeking for your protection. We are seeking for your favor. We are seeking for your guidance. We are asking you, O Lord, may you be with us this week, that we might not step our legs, our foot on the troubled waters, but help us, O Lord, to raise our life above the ugly waters. Lord God Almighty, we commit our minister and the family. We commit each and every one of us that have gathered today, O Lord, pleading and praying that you protect us. Help us that as we are in the Thanksgiving moment, Thanksgiving week, that we shall be able to remain thankful unto you. Father in heaven, we therefore commit the food that is presented as an expression of the appreciation to the things which you have done unto us. May you bless the hands that prepared it. Bless us, O Lord, that we may use it to nourish our physical flesh. Continue to bless those who are in need of such, that at due season, O Lord, they will receive theirs. Be with us as we depart. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray. Amen.
Amen.